What is up, ladies and gentlemen? My name is LoverFella, and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved. Yesterday, I was playing on this server, just kind of hanging around, trying to tame a little dinosaur, and I took our Quetzal and flew it into, like, basically another war Quetzal that mowed me down and killed it. So, yeah, that was pretty fun. And it looks like the people in the tribe, the awesome tribe members we have, basically everyone collectively has been online throughout this process while we try to raise two brand new, extremely strong high-level Quetzals, because we need a Quetzal, man. We need a Quetzal to tame stuff. We need a Quetzal to get metal and all that good fun stuff. Along with that, you can see we have a beautiful new Rex army, which apparently just popped up over the last course of 24 hours. And we got some new Spinosaurus over here, which I just saw recently. Finally, we have a Giga somewhere. I saw him earlier when I was online. At least I think we have a Giga. They could be raiding for all I know. Long story short, let me explain to you guys what happened yesterday. I meant to upload Ark yesterday, and I ended up doing Planet Coaster instead, which if you haven't watched, I really think you should watch it, because it's a fantastic series, and super fun game, and I'm probably going to be playing it a little bit more in the future. I was cleaning out my computer because my hard drive's getting full, because I have so many videos recorded and saved. So I basically went through and deleted all my videos, and in the process of doing that, I actually deleted the video I meant to upload that day, and I was like, oh, that's a bummer, but that's okay. I thought I'll just re-render it and get it again. But then I realized I also deleted the recording for it. So, I mean, that kind of sucked. But lesson learned, make sure next time that I absolutely have the correct videos going. Because, you know, we all make mistakes when we make videos. I probably once a week make some kind of weird mistake like that where I lose a recording. What is this? Is this a dude? Gardener. What? Give the gardener beer and he'll collect crops for you. Oh, that's so cool. Wow. I should take these crops out of here so I don't go bad. But anyway, that's what happened yesterday. And if you guys are curious, those of you who only watch Ark videos, these next few days, I'm actually leaving tomorrow, which will be today when you're watching it. Like Wednesday, I am going home to see my family, see my cats and my brothers. Haven't seen them in actually a really long time because I've been so busy with college. And I'm going to be there to celebrate Thanksgiving for a couple of days. And won't be here to make videos. So basically, I'm trying to push out some videos, like trying to make like 3 to 4 a day so I have some stuff prepared for you guys. The reason I'm not doing Ark for all of them is because honestly, I'm just like you guys. I get burnt out. I'm a normal human being. I can't stand that much Ark or that much anything. So I have to take breaks just to keep my sanity. Hope you guys understand that. And I really hope you give the other games a chance because they're super, super fun. Okay, turning up the game a little bit. I'm gonna show you guys a couple more things that they've done. And after today, I won't be on for a few days. Like I said, I'll be in, home for Thanksgiving, which means basically there's going to be a huge amount of progress next time you watch a video. And so what I decided to do, instead of just giving you all of my Ark videos back to back to back and then load you up with Planet Coaster or whatever other game I choose to do to fill those voids, I think I'm going to alternate days for this break, because I don't want you guys to like watch it and then take like a 5-day break off and not watch anything, kind of forget about it. I kind of want to like make sure it's like coming in every other day at the very least. That way we still have some content, and if you guys like the other series, oh, we got Metal Gates now, that's pretty nice. So if you like the other series, you can watch those too, but I'm going to be releasing these every other day, and then next week, once I get back, it's going to be like a ridiculous amount of progress. I'm assuming that these guys are going to do a lot of stuff, but it's been pretty fun playing with them. Pretty fun playing with this tribe. We've got a lot of great things accomplished. Unfortunately, if I can fly here a little bit, actually, I'll be honest with you guys, I just had 3 slices of bacon before I recorded. Made my fingers a little greasy and my buttons are now a little greasy. I gotta give my keyboard a bath later. But dinosaur wise, we're killing it. We got some crazy strong dinos. We got a pretty decent base spot. Other than the fact that we're not quite up the mountain yet, we're kind of like way lower than we intended to be. But here's the deal. We don't have very many turrets, and I keep meaning to go on like a turret run to get like a whole bunch of materials for turrets and just grind them out, because we could set up like little generators and like possible one by one foundations up here, like turret towers all over the walls. We could set up like side building sniper towers, stuff like that, along with a sniper turret tower up here and on their base and all that stuff. This area right here is an area where we want turret towers, all these giant rocks, all that stuff. And I guess my mind's kind of stuck on like when I play on a high rate server and I could make millions and millions of turret towers and stuff all the time. But here I can't. And I think that's part of the reason why I die with our Quetzal, because, you know, look at those black boxes. Do you see that? That's so annoying. Something with the center map, I guess, is a glitch. So sorry for you guys to have to see it. Oh, and then one final thing. Actually, this is what I recorded yesterday, but I can't show you guys. Press backspace to get rid of the millions of green names. I basically segmented this main room right here. I added like some walls over here. Someone actually tinted them for me, which I meant to do, and kind of expanded our space. This is a glass wall. You can't walk over there, but it was too open for the center of the room. And I think the problem is when you have a tribe of so many people, that a lot of people don't want to add onto a building because they're like, well, someone built this. They clearly have a way they want it to look. I don't want to mess it up. And this is what I kind of did, just to kind of segment it more, make it a little bit harder to get in. The more layers, the more onion-like your base is, the better it is. And finally, I think for now, we are probably planning on slowing down on accepting new people into the tribe. I get about, honestly, 15 to 20 messages per day asking to join the tribe, which is great. I love that many people want to play with us, but just because of how busy I am right now with school, I can't deal with that many people asking me to join, trying to keep everyone happy. I forget people all the time who want in. So those of you who I've talked to, we'll try to get you in. I'm not going to be here for a while, but I'm sure I can talk to the tribe mates, have them accept you. But I don't think we're going to take new applications for people, at least until we see that we need more people. Because we have so many, I'm letting anyone in right now, basically. I don't want to get someone that I can't trust in here. Most of the people who I am inviting are people who I've seen in my comments for a long time. People that I know I can trust. So I just want to get that out there right now. That is basically on hold right now. You're going to have to wait until I figure out if we need more people or not, because I just don't know. We're huge, and I don't want to become to the point where there's just too many people to manage. You know what I'm saying? It's basically just hard to get to a point where I can meet you on the server. So that's the worst part about it. I can't come find you all, and I can't tell if you're trustworthy. And one more announcement I want to make while I'm running around. I think we're preparing for a raid today, which will be fun. A lot of people, I put a survey out there on our video, and I saw that a lot of people actually play on Xbox. In fact, most of you do play on Xbox, which makes sense because Xbox is pretty cheap compared to a gaming PC that could run this kind of game. And I feel like I may have raised a lot of expectations because a lot of people are really excited for when I get an Xbox to play with you guys. And I just want to talk about that for a second to those Xbox people. And I feel like I may have raised your hopes too much because right now, I'm just going to say it, I've said it before, but I'm not in a situation to get an Xbox at all. And in fact, I don't think I'm going to be able to get one for at least another year at the minimum because I have a really powerful gaming PC. And getting an Xbox would just be a massive downgrade to what I play on. And once you go from a high frame rate, high FPS, to a very low quality system, it tends to make me very sick. You get kind of dizzy, you get nauseous. While I'm looking at the frame rates, looking at the graphics, it's weird to explain it, honestly. It's weird to say that, but you may not notice a difference going from Xbox to PC, but once you go back down, you'll notice this difference that's so strong, it makes you super sick, and it's just a huge downgrade. I think you guys all know that. Gaming PC is obviously way more powerful than an Xbox. There's just no comparison. And getting an Xbox, something that I would only use to play with you guys, never to record on, because again, it'd be lower quality, it's not something I would do. So the only reason I'd get it is to just play with some of you guys who want to play with me. So as you can see, it is basically an extremely luxury item for me right now. So I get comments daily about it. I want to get you guys' expectations under control. Make sure you understand. I can hardly afford rent right now. Truly, honestly, I'm not asking you for money or anything like that. I'm just explaining. I can hardly afford my rent. I have maybe 2 months left in me before I start not being able to afford it. But I should start work soon for the next semester and it'll be fine. But, guys, understand it. I wish I could get it right now. I wish I could walk out and get it, play with you guys, have fun with you like I do with some of the people here, but I just can't. So, thanks for understanding. So, while we're planning this raid, I might record the raid in a separate video because, I'm trying to pre-record a whole bunch of stuff right now. I'm going to go ahead and try to kill some stuff with my bird. This isn't even technically my bird. It's just one of the birds I saw, but it's named Argent, and I kind of love that about that. So I kind of want to just claim this one. Hopefully no one's using it in the tribe. Know what I'm saying? And level it up a little bit, get some nice stats into it, and talk about something that I haven't talked about in a while, something that I'm really happy to be bringing back to you guys today, and that is a nice little inspirational speech. And, okay, so let me just start this right off. Talking to you guys about, I haven't done them in a while. I haven't been being inspirational. I haven't been talking about super crazy awesome things and making you guys super happy. At least that's what I feel like. And part of it is because I feel like I've been in a funk, you know? Sometimes, do you guys ever just feel like you're not yourself or you just feel off? You feel tired. Maybe you just don't feel inspired. I don't know how to explain it. You just kind of feel not yourself. That's kind of how I felt for, what level is this guy? I should probably. Is he super high? I saw 100. This might take a really long time to kill, but that's okay. So I've just not felt like myself. I felt just kind of off, little whatever, and I couldn't figure out why. I couldn't figure out what was wrong, and I was like, man, you have almost 5,000 subs now. Your channel has never done better. You're doing all right in school. I mean, you're at least passing your classes, and it's doing okay. So what's wrong? And I realized that in life, there's a natural ebb and flow. Sometimes you're going to be happy. Sometimes you're not going to be happy, and I think this guy's too much health. I'm out of here. I'm not going to kill that thing. It's going to take way too long. But basically, sometimes you're not going to be happy. Like, no matter what you do, you're just not going to be feeling inspired. You're not going to be feeling like you can do anything. Even though you might believe it deep down that you can do whatever you're trying to do, you're not going to feel like you can do it. You're just going to feel bad for whatever reason. You might not be able to pinpoint, and that's where I was. And I realized that life's kind of like an ocean, at least to me. This is completely made up. I don't know if it's true, but I think there's a natural ebb and flow to happiness and not happiness. Some days you feel happy for no reason, some days you don't. And you can't force yourself to feel happy on days where you're not. Likewise, you can't force yourself to be unhappy on days where you're happy, because things that would normally upset you won't upset you on those days. And so here's the deal. I realized that you have to accept that emotion you're feeling for that day. You have to accept that maybe today you're not feeling the best, and you can't force it. You have to accept it, allow yourself. Oh my gosh, look at that bass up there. Whoa, it's all blue. I just see it rendering in. I'm not sure whose bass that is. I'm assuming this door has to do with it. I'm going to check real quick. What is this? What is this? This is Intercore. Ooh, I know Intercore is a pretty big tribe around here. I'm going to stay away from their base. But you have to allow yourself to feel those emotions, whatever they are. Like, if you're stressed, don't try to put that stress away and hide it. Don't try to squish it out of your life. Feel that stress, accept the stress, like feel the emotion, and like once you allow yourself to feel it, you're gonna be okay. And here's why. This is like the main point of this. I think your body knows what it wants to feel. Your body knows what it needs to feel better. So if you feel stressed or sad, feel it, and then you're gonna feel better. Like, allow yourself, just accept it to get out of that funk, and you're gonna be feeling great. And the reason I think that's true is because, what is going on here? A little raptor taking him out. The reason I know that's true is because this is actually scientifically proven, and it's that. You guys ever like go into your like fridge after you're like lowering your standards, you keep opening the door, coming back, and finally you're like, okay, fine, I'll have that cookie. Once you eat that cookie, have you ever super craved like a little bit of meat? Like, you eat a cookie and you're like, man, I really want a piece of salami or something. If you don't understand what I'm saying, pay attention next time you have something really sweet, and you'll probably be craving a little bit of salt, maybe a little bit of meat. And the reason is because your body's telling, oh gosh, well, that's not a good place to go down. The reason is because you're craving that is because your body is saying like, hey, you just ate sugar, you need a little bit of salt or whatever it is to balance it out. Your body knows what it needs. And a lot of dietitians or like nutritionists, whichever one's the official one, they say if you listen to what you want, like what your body craves, you're pretty able to stay healthy that way. Like, if you crave salt, go eat yourself some salt and you'll probably be okay. If you need like sugar, go eat some sugar, you're gonna be okay. Like, if you follow those instincts, you're gonna be okay. So I started thinking about that, and I was like, that might apply to emotions as well, and like a mental thing. If you feel like you want to be sad, then be sad, because I don't know why, I'm not like an expert at this, but I feel like once you accept it, once you just say, hey, it's time to be sad, you're going to get over it, and then you'll get back out of that funk. Otherwise, if you suppress it, you're going to stay sad for a really long time, or uninspired, not feeling yourself, whatever the case may be. That's what's going to happen for an extremely long time until you allow yourself to feel that bad emotion. That is just something that I've been thinking about the last day. I really just kind of wanted to share that with you, like see what you guys think about it, if that's something you believe or support. Maybe it's actually true. I don't know. But I think that's something that I'm going to start following a lot. Like, if you have a bad day or something, which happens to all of us, go ahead and accept it. Take that bad day for what it is and just, you know, enjoy it. I mean, let it happen. Let it follow its course. Think of it as an ocean. Waves come, waves go, but the waves will always come back. And they're always going to come back. They're always going to go away. You can't control it. So I'm not saying you can't control your emotions. I'm not saying that's impossible. I'm just saying, I don't know, guys. I'm just ranting right now, okay? I'm just ranting. So once these Quetzals, completely different topic now, get built up, we're going to go for some serious metal harvesting sprees. It's going to be really fun to do. And, I guess I don't mind harvesting metal. So when I say fun, I mean like it's not going to suck to do. So we're going to get a bunch of metal. Who's this guy? What's up, Dovakim? I love his purple, man. It looks good. So we're going to do that, get a bunch of,
Hey, LoverFella.
What's up, dude? By the way, there's a guy who messaged me, basically like a private message. He said he's a solo, but he's like pretty strong on the server, and he said he wants to raid us sometime after this Wednesday, so we got to get a lot of turrets by then. He said he'll try to do it when I'm online. All right, guys, I've just been hanging out with Charge inside of our cave down there, just kind of talking some strategy, what we're going to do, potential raids in the future, nothing really too crazy, just, you know, making sure everything under control before I'm gone, basically, for a long time. Doing stuff at home, you know how it is. We should get a quick battle between two people to record. That'd be pretty funny. We can do crossbows maybe. All right, guys, so right now is the first ever LoverFella tribe battle. We're going to do a 2v2, 12 shots only, naked rifle shootout. Loser has to eat their own poop. It's me in charge against Dovahkiin and Name. I'm actually really excited for this. I want to do something fun today. Didn't really want to tame something because I'm not going to be able to spend that much time taming. So I thought, let's do it for the first annual naked rifle shoot. You know what I'm saying? So I'm waiting for Name to find us. He's completely lost right now. And I'm probably gonna die first. So maybe I'll just hide somewhere. I'll kick him out of the tribe. That's what I'll do. Kick him out of the tribe, make the plant turret, shoot him, and I'll win. Right? That's fair. And I get this guy. I get to ride into battle on a cat because it's majestic. Yeah! I could have killed him right there.
Okay, Name. Remove your armor, and everyone remove the name tags, okay? So we can't see each other's name.
And no cheating.
And no
got
cheating.
Got it.
Well, help.
Sweet.
Got it.
Name. We shoot the black guy.
Armor. Name.
Hey.
No.
No.
Yes. Target. Target that.
Crap, I'm out of here. Crap, I'm out.
No scopes, no name tags. Let's have a nice, clean, fair fight. Let's touch guns. Whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa. Let's touch guns. I'm changing gun color real quick. 1 second. Oh, it's still green.
Oh, we got the blue guy. Still green. Okay, let's go. Three.
I'm coming for you.
Two.
Purple gun.
One.
Go. All right, guys, this is it. The annual no scope competition. Me and Charge versus those two. All right, this is it. This is it. Loser eats the poop. We're there. I don't know who's on my team. We turn names off. Oh, boy.
In the glass. They can see.
Oh, they went in the glass so they can see us. They're camping in there. Let's do this. I don't hear any gunshots. What? Oh gosh, I actually just yelled. That was like super loud. I live in an apartment. I can't be doing that. Where'd they go? Oh my gosh. Come on, boys. Where are you at? This is such a waste of ammo on a low-rate server. They can so see me though. They're probably in the center room. 100% they're in the center room. I know it. Oh man, this is stressful. This is so stressful. Let's go, boys. I know they're in here. Let's go. Right here. They're looking at me. All right, I need a strategy for this. My gun is a different color so they can tell it's me. Didn't mean to do that, so they know who I am. Maybe they went outside. Fake out. I'm going out. No, I'm not. I'm going to have to go in this main room. I'm going to have to do it. I'm going to have to go. Boom. No. There we go. Got to get a peek in there. Are they in there? I'm gonna run all the way through it. Let's go. Go. Okay, there, no one shot me. Where are they at? Wait, there's someone. Is that my guy? I don't know if that's my teammate. No, it's not, because my teammate doesn't have the weird neck. One more left. He killed one of them. I didn't even hear a shoot, man. That was a silent kill. That's what I'm talking about. Should I camp right here? Should I camp in this corner? Let's play some Call of Duty, boys. No scopes. I bet he went into the turtle cave. That's where he went. Would they have gone down here? I feel like this is off limits. I'm gonna check it anyway. Oh, I don't have any ammo in this gun. I got the wrong gun. Which gun? I gotta press back. Oh, that's charge. Sorry, I cheated, but I had to get the right gun out. Just gotta eat this guy. This is military crawl style. We gotta get up there. We gotta find him. We gotta take him down. Looks like those two birds are just going so nicely together. What if we get up here on this guy? Aerial view of the base. Oh, that's gotta be him. That's gotta be him, right behind the Argent. I'm gonna do a full-on kamikaze, 360 no scope. Oh, I hit something. I think I hit a bird. I just saw him in there. I know. That's Name. That's my teammate. That was a good 360 though. Oh my gosh, there he is. I found him, he just came out of the door. This is it. This is the moment. He's running off the edge, he's going suicidal. Oh my gosh, he brought parachutes. Next level. He's gone. Here he comes back. I just saw him go out of bounds. Going back for him. There he is. That's a hit. That's a clean no scope hit right there. There he is. I got him. Oh my gosh. Look at that. I want to play that shot again in slow motion. That was absolutely freaking beautiful. Oh my goodness. Jeez, he had a lot of stuff on. I'm just going to leave his body here. 1v1 you, rip, no beds. Are there really no beds? All right, guess we have no beds apparently somehow. What? Was someone rearranging the base and destroyed the beds somehow? What the crap? Charge wants to 1v1 me. He has no idea that I'm actually right here. I'm going to see if he pops in this door and just give him a nice old boom to the face. No! I missed. Oh, no. Let's go. There it is. Boom. First place, baby. First place. That's what I like to see. Yes. That means I'm the best. He tried to 360 me. Well, I guess he's the best. All right, let's get these beds placed down so the tribe can respawn. I don't know why we had no bases in here. That was so fun. Oh my gosh. Thank you guys for playing that with me. That was pretty awesome. Although, you know, I'm the champion. Unsurprisingly, I'm kind of the best player ever. Hashtag sarcasm. Let's get all my armor, all my stuff taken back out of this dinosaur that I put it in here. I didn't want to take their stuff because I didn't want to have to reorganize it and sort and give it back to them. But that charge was killed by Rex. Well, it looks like someone didn't respawn at the bed. That about sums up this video for today. Hope you guys had a lot of fun watching it. This one was a lot of fun to make. That was really fun to do. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you guys are just having an awesome day. Hope you have a great week and a good Thanksgiving. If you're American, you celebrate the killing of the Indians, which is kind of what it is. Not going to talk about that. Anyway, guys, love you all. I'll see you all tomorrow.